When viewing an object in the real world, we converge our eyes' line of sight to fuse the images of the object into two eyes. We also focus or accommodate to the same distance so that the object is seen as sharp. Conventional stereoscopic displays use binocular vergence cues to indicate distance, but the viewer must always accommodate to the fixed distance of the screen to create a sharp retinal image. This is a problem because vergence and accommodation are coupled in the brain, so the conflict causes viewer discomfort and fatigue and perceptual distortions. Multiplane displays provide a potential solution to this problem, presenting images at multiple distances that combine additively in the eye. By assigning image data to different planes, a range of accommodative distances can be achieved. Such displays have been constructed using a system of beam splitters or using high-speed switchable lenses with time multiplexing to change the apparent distance of the monitor. The problem we address in this work is how to assign image data to different planes to reproduce an arbitrary scene, such as this example of two opaque rectangles as focus changes from far to near. Existing techniques blend each pixel to the two nearest planes by linear interpolation, but this results in very noticeable artifacts near occlusion boundaries. Some edges are incorrectly sharp, some are incorrectly darkened, and halos become visible. Our algorithm takes the input focus stack and computes the images to present on the display planes to best match the desired scene over a range of accommodative distances. This technique overcomes the artifacts of linear blending to a significant degree. Here we show a rendered scene with salient reflections and refractions, such as the armadillo in the mirror. These non-Lambertian effects cannot always be assigned a single consistent distance. Linear blending does not accurately reproduce these effects, incorrectly placing them at the distance of the specular surface. Artifacts are also visible at occlusion boundaries. Optimization correctly reproduces the behavior of the reflected and refracted imagery, as well as high-quality occlusion edges. Here we show a sequence of photographs taken of the actual display as we change the focus distance of the camera. The camera aperture is chosen to be representative of human pupil size. The appearance of the displayed imagery in the photographs is consistent with the simulated images. The system also supports animation at up to 45 frames per second, and even though the frames are optimized independently, we get no temporal artifacts. Here we show simulated retinal images. On the actual display, the animation appears very high in quality to human viewers, but temporal aliasing between the camera and the monitor makes it difficult to capture a representative video. Because we only require a focus stack and no geometrical information, it's straightforward to acquire imagery from a real scene and display it using our method. Again, we show photographs of the actual display. Light fields can also be used as input to our algorithm. As a proof of concept, we use imagery from a LightRow light field camera as input. To compensate for the limited angular resolution of the camera, we use an artificially large aperture for these sequences. In the future, the resolution of light field cameras will increase, making it possible to use their images without modification. This in turn will make it possible to acquire and display high-quality imagery of real-world scenes with accurate accommodation cues. Please see the paper for a detailed analysis of the method, including resolution limits and perceptual metrics.